Benjamin, or preferably Benny, didn't have the most ideal of upbringings. His father didn't take an interest in his son's endeavors.
What's for babies?
And his mother? Well, she was preoccupied with other meaningful pursuits. Now, school. That was an entirely different matter. It's not as if his peers didn't pay attention to him.
Something in all this, yes. We'll do it. By God, we will do it, Cavill.
Wonderful! I'll start on the plans and the moldings this very night.
Start on the plans right now.
Trip, I should think.
But after all, Cavill, what do you expect to find?
20th century, the United States was facing a serious crisis. America was coming into its own as an industrial giant, but its young men had gone off to fight in World War I. This had shrunk the labor force needed to keep the country's economic engine going. Cotton fields in the Southwest, beet fields across the plains, and steel mills in the Midwest all needed workers to fill the acute wartime labor shortage. And everywhere, the railroads, the backbone of the country, needed to maintain and expand thousands of miles of aging track. At this crossroads, at this time of desperate need, the United States turned to immigrant workers from one country in particular for help. That country wasn't Italy, or Ireland, or Poland, or any other whose people passed through Ellis Island at this time. That country was Mexico. But they were also drawn by rumors that a better life was possible in the United States. There's work in the United States, the rumors ran, and they want a lot of us. Get to the border, and you won't need to look for work. It will come looking for you. Railroads were looking and paying $3.50 a day, 10 times the rate back home in Guanajuato or Jalisco or Zacatecas. In Galesburg, Illinois, two railroads, the Chicago, Burlington, and Quincy, and the Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe, were hiring. They provided the transportation, a job, and, most importantly for these uprooted Mexicans, a place to live and raise a family. They provided a home.
My name is Jenny Padilla Vasquez.
We were 21 years old, so what's happened? 4.5 years I'm gone, I come back to this shit? What is this, some sort of quota bullshit? Hey, first they take over our neighborhoods, now they're gonna take over our jobs? What the fuck you gotta say about that, man?
DWI.
DWI.
And that's all I have to say about it. Your breath mints and your mouthwash, that stuff fooled people in high school. That's not gonna fly here.
Yeah.
You're drunk now.
What are you talking about? I'm not just drunk right now.
Yeah, you some help.
No, I came here for some fucking help, Sean.
You're not gonna get it. Sorry.
For he that says his blood with me shall be my brother. See, I dig that section, man. You know what I mean? That shit pretty tight because I understand what he's saying. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, it's good. It's good. Doing a good job. Now all you have to do is memorize the whole thing.
And I memorize it. That's not the problem, though.
What's the problem, man?
I'm saying, like, when I get in front of people, man, I just go blank.
Tell me you get stage fright?
I don't know. I guess so, man.
Let me ask you a question. 4 years ago in the high school state championship, mm-hmm. How many people were at that game?
Man, it was a lot of people, man. It was probably about like 8,000.
Do you ever still talk to her?
What?
I mean, Do you ever still have made-up conversations between the two of you, or dialogue?
The other night, I had a dream about her. I'd almost forgotten what she sounded like. It felt so good. Just as if nothing had changed. And we just sat in the garden and talked. I miss her soft voice. When I woke up,
they barely mentioned the thing.
Well, they had an article in the paper.
15 seconds? I mean, what is that? 15 seconds, that's all I gave them.
I'm sorry, John.
If it's all right, I'd like to stop by a little bit later. There's a few things I want to talk to you about.
Mm-hmm.